Rabbi Yesuda Levin has a problem with the Lakewood Blue Claws Pride Night. He's a Lakewood rabbi who ran against Ed Koch for mayor of New York. He's organizing a protest tomorrow night. He's got a couple of videos out. Definitely anti-gay, definitely joining us right now. Rabbi Levin, thank you for coming on.
Well, thank you very much. You gave the weather, you said it was something like 71 degrees, but under my collar, it's around 96 degrees, and I'll tell you why.
Tell me why. What's the matter? You're hot under the collar, Rabbi. What's going on?
That's it. That's that. Steve, listen, bro. When I want to attack somebody, I like to do it, you know, if I give them a chance. You know, why didn't you call up and ask me for an interview? I'll be happy to come on.
We tried. I swear, Rabbi, we tried. There's no way to contact you. I had my producer do it. I did it. I Googled you. I tried to get you, but I'm glad you're here.
It's the first I'm hearing because I have an email and I have a phone number. And people get in touch with me for years. I've been doing this stuff for 40 years. But anyhow, let's get it on, bro. What's the problem exactly?
I want to ask you, what's the problem?
Sir,
I mean, you're confrontational now. Tell me what the problem is. Why do you have a problem that the Lakewood Blue Claws want to have a Pride Night? It's Pride Month. What's the problem?
By the way, why is it Pride Month and why is there no Happy Heterosexual Month? You know, I feel very discriminated against. At least if you would say to me, Blue Claws is going to make happy heterosexuals for a month, and then they're going to do the gay stuff. Okay, maybe you're right.
Well, I think every night is Happy Heterosexual Month, right? I mean, I celebrate my heterosexuality. Do you?
I'm asking you. I haven't seen any pride in heterosexuality. I only see it coming into an ultra-religious neighborhood where it's not the community standards. In other words, do you know, you ever heard of Judge Learned Hand? He said,
I don't care what he said. I care about what the people feel. And the people of Lakewood, you can't say, are totally anti-gay. You know, you can't speak for an entire community, nor can you speak for an entire... You can't even speak for your entire flock unless you talk to everyone there and get their feelings. You're now trying to speak for everybody, and that's wrong.
Okay, Steve, let's do this. I'm happy to talk to you, but we got to do something. I know it's hard for you to understand, but we've got to do something called being fair.
So I'm being very fair. I'm giving you time, and I'm asking you questions.
No, you're not. You cut me off already twice.
Well, do me a favor. Let's just tell me how you think. Forget about dropping names. And I have time constraints here, so tell me how you feel. I'll let you go. Go ahead.
Do me a favor. Don't cut me off. Tell me you have a minute and then keep quiet for that minute. Tell me whatever it is, but stop the cutting off stuff and don't tell me if I'm being fair or not.
Don't tell me how to run my show. I'll tell you exactly how. If it's my opinion, just like you're telling me your opinion. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you 60 seconds. Ready? Go.
Wow, that's very generous of you. The fact of the matter is that community standards in a particular location should be honored, especially when the majority of the people paying the tax dollars do not want a library that is celebrating things in public that should not be in the living room. It should be best left of the bedroom. Now, we understand that the homosexual side is in ascendancy, and they want to push it into our schools, shove us into our churches, then tell us our churches are bigoted, and they basically want to brainwash children and youth. And therefore, we feel it's inappropriate in this particular venue, just like it's inappropriate to tell us that we have to have locker rooms or bathrooms that we have to share with people who have a delusion that they're men or that they're ladies when they're opposite genders. It's just too crazy. It's too much. That's simple. Very simple. Leave us alone.
Okay. My rebuttal. First of all, to start off with the libraries, I don't think you should be controlling what comes in and out of a library, a free public library, and you put all the information in there, let people make their own decisions. As far as the community beliefs, again, you can't speak for everyone. And as far as the laws about bathroom use, that's passed on a state level, not a Lakewood level. So are you part of the state? Are you part of the country? Or are you running your own little country there? Your turn.
Steve, respectfully, there's a very weak intellectual argument. Nobody is talking about censorship.
Well, I'll try to get stronger next time we talk, Rabbi. Seriously.
Exactly. You should really prepare better. But let me speak. Stop cutting off.
Hey, dude, you called me, and I'm talking to you, and I'm giving you. You want to be argumentative, but you're not telling me. You know, you're not defending yourself against my points, which are valid.
I said very clearly to you, but you're obfuscating. There's one thing to censor books. There's another thing to make a display in a youth section of a public library about bedroom behaviors of any sort or misbehaviors. It has no place. So that requires a level of civilization and gentility.
I mean, now, wait a minute. Are we talking about the Blue Claws night, or are we talking about the library? Where are we? Are we talking about, and by the way,
I know it might be too hard for you to keep two balls juggling at the same time. But
I wish I could be as intelligent as you, Rabbi. I wish I could just give, you know, spew my opinion and have people follow it. Unfortunately, nobody's following it.
If you try hard, you might understand that we feel we're under attack.
Tonight we're going to do Are You Smarter Than Rabbi Levin? Go ahead.
Do you hear the point that I'm making? The difference.
I hear the point, but I'm talking about the Blue Claws night, and now you're talking about libraries. We're talking about apples and oranges, or stadiums and libraries, wherever you want to go. Go ahead.
Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
Do you understand that in our literature we said it is the homosexualization of society against the desires in our schools, in our streets, in our stadiums, in our libraries, and we believe...
But they're not yours. They belong to the state of New Jersey. No.
So they can do whatever they want,
provided it's legal.
Steve,
go ahead.
One second. Steve, you're telling me now that when Martin Luther King marched for civil rights, if everybody didn't agree with him, you cannot make a rally or protest. I mean, you're really...
I'm telling you that people are entitled to their own opinions and whether or not they want to go to the game. Don't change my words and don't flip them. I'm going to give you 30 seconds before I have to hang up because I've got this commercial break I got to hit. And I got people holding on right now.
It's very good. I think that everybody hears what's going on here.
Okay.
They're gradually tightening the noose on how we can raise our own children on the values, and they're not happy if they do it in Greenwich Village or wherever it's San Francisco.
Rabbi, you're missing the point, if I may, and I've been listening, and respectfully, you are missing the point. Times have changed. You know, and the LGBTQ community has grown into more acceptance than ever. And it sounds like you can't accept it. And that's where the problem lies. You're still living in the Ed Koch 70s or the Ed Koch 60s. And I think that's the biggest problem here. I do need to hang up now, though, because I do have to hit a break. Can we leave this on a good note?
We can leave it on a good note if you'll allow me one sentence.
Just one sentence. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Biblical morality for you might change, but for us, it's very serious.
All right, and let's see how serious it is by who shows up. And, you know, that's all I can say. I understand where you're coming from, and I really have no problem with you.
Right and wrong is not a numbers game.
All right. Thank you for the call, Rabbi, to New Jersey 101.5.